Hey guys, I'm Sarah. Every week I comb through hundreds of DIY videos preparing projects for our weekly maker show, Maker Break. Along the way, I find some good projects and some great ones, and right now I'm gonna share them with you. This is Sarah's top 5 DIY coffee cup displays. All right, let's get started with number 5. Scotty Turner started his build off at the miter saw to cut the long and short pieces that would make up the frame for his display. Then he headed to the table saw to rip down all of his boards to 5 inches wide. Once the frame was glued up and nailed together, it was time to build and attach the shelves for the mugs. He used a stop block on his miter saw to make quick work of cutting all of the supports for the shelves. Using his circular saw, he cut out the hardboard backing. The final assembly was done with a nailer, and after a few coats of stain, it was ready for some coffee cups. All right, home built workshop is number 4. This was a commission piece, and the client needed this thing to be a big project to fit all of their coffee mugs. Jeff started by cutting all of his boards to length. He needed 7 boards for the front and 3 supporting boards on the back. He glued and nailed all of the boards together, making sure he used his spacer and a square to guarantee they all lined up perfectly. He added pegs for extra stability, but he said that this might have been a little overkill, but since it was for someone else's home, he would rather be extra safe than sorry. Jeff then drilled all of the holes for the pegs that the mugs would eventually hang from, and then he got them glued into place. After a beautiful coat of stain, this was ready to be delivered. Next up is number 3. Land to House started off his coffee mug display with the frame. He cut all 4 pieces with a 45 degree angle on the ends so there was no end grain showing. Once he glued up all of the corners, he pre-drilled holes and used a small nail and hammer to keep it all together. But if you have a nailer, that would be way easier and a whole lot faster. Next, he added the vertical dividers at 6-inch increments to give plenty of clearance for different sized coffee mugs. Then he added the little shelves. All that was left was to add some paint, mount it on the wall, and add all the coffee cups. Now the only thing that I would change here would be using less conspicuous hardware to mount it on the wall, but besides that, I love this. Number 2 is the DIY cottage. Bria started off her project, like most projects, by cutting all of her boards to the proper length. For her version of a coffee cup display, she used scrap wood that she had laying around, but you could easily just use new lumber. Once she figured out how much space she needed for the cups to hang without bumping into each other, she attached the back supports that would be mounted on the wall to the front pieces. Next, she painted the top piece with chalk paint so she could add fun notes and little messages. Then she got to hang all of the hooks for the coffee cups. This is such a cute and easy project that could really free up some cabinet space. Last but not least is Make Everything, coming in at number 1. You know how it goes. You buy 4 more coffee cups, even though you already have like 3 or 10, and well, now you need more space to store them. Completely normal. I have more coffee cups than I can count. Just move past this. Make Everything went a completely different route with his coffee cup display and decided in order to properly store his new collection pieces, he needed to weld himself a shelf. He made the top using angle iron so that the wooden shelf would actually rest within the frame. Then he welded the base of the little shelf and attached it to the top. Then using a template, he fabricated these swirls for a pretty design element for the back and the sides. He seriously makes this look so easy. This is awesome. All right, do me a favor and like this video. And if you have not already subscribed to Belts and Boxes, what are you waiting for? Go do that now and hit the bell so you don't miss any of our shows that come out during the week. You can catch me every Friday at 5 p.m. for the next episode of Week in Review with Rob, and every Saturday at noon for Make or Break. We'll see you then.